TikTok, an app that's had over 2 billion downloads across 154 countries. The first Chinese social media app to gain big traction outside of China, it's formed a part of our daily lives over the past few months, where lockdown has turned many of us into TikTok addicts. But recently, concerns have been raised when it comes to the app's ownership history. TikTok was bought by multi-million dollar ByteDance, which in turn is partly owned by the Chinese government. One Reddit user decided to inspect the app's code to determine if TikTok is actually a data collection service that disguises itself as social media. The post's author stresses the fact that, a few months ago, a leak was found to be publicizing people's primary and secondary email addresses, real names, birthdays, and more. They claim that TikTok is using as many APIs as possible to gather information about its users. APIs are tools that grant access to features and information on a user's smartphone. Grab yourself a seat while I read just some of the details this Redditor has found to be at risk. Your phone's CPU and hardware information, screen dimensions, its memory usage, its disk space, information about other apps installed on your phone, network information including your IP address, MAC address, Wi-Fi access point information, whether or not your phone is jailbroken, and even GPS-based location data which refreshes every 30 seconds. And even if only some of this is true, none of it is advertised as a feature of downloading and installing the so-called social media app. More than 2,000 comments express their own concerns and experiences with the app, many of which highlight some alarming trends that they believe will make users more compliant with potential Chinese infiltration. They say that the sense of virality entices young users to stay on the platform. Despite the intense allegations against the Chinese-owned company, one TikTok spokesperson highlighted that the company is led by an American CEO, with hundreds of employees and key leaders across safety, security, product, and public policy in the US. The company stresses that its data centers are located outside of China, which means that any information collected by the app would not succumb to Chinese laws. Furthermore, we're told that US user data is stored internally within the United States, with a backup being made in Singapore, but nothing in China. Even the US government has its concerns with the app. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said that the country would be looking at banning Chinese social media apps, including TikTok. Wanting to get this one right, he said he didn't want to get out in front of the president. It was later confirmed by President Trump that the ban is almost definitely under consideration, who suggested that this would be a retaliation against China for its alleged role in the COVID-19 pandemic. He said, "Look what happened with China with the virus, what they've done to this country and to the entire world is disgraceful." Although this news comes at a time of tension between the US and China, particularly regarding national security, trade and technology, Trump has faced criticism against his racist remarks. Pompeo suggested that people should only use the app if they want their private information in the hands of the Chinese Communist Party. But it hasn't always been plain sailing. In fact, the app has already faced criticism from the Indian government, where it and other popular Chinese apps such as WeChat have undergone censorship in the country. Its government said that it would ban apps like TikTok because they engage in activities prejudicial to the sovereignty and integrity of India. Recently, tensions have been rising between both countries elsewhere too, with clashes along the Himalayan border just one example. Both cases of India and the US challenging Chinese social media, including TikTok, come at times where the countries are under threat by China. With political tensions running high, we must ask whether the considered moves against Chinese social media are purely a fight of fire with fire, or a step to help the US retain its world-leading role. The future of the app remains uncertain. Although TikTok has become a popular household name over the past year, its increasing resistance is proving challenging to the company. Let's not forget Vine, a very similar app that rose to heightened popularity before completely disappearing. One thing is for certain. While governments are raising their concerns and taking time to investigate the app, TikTok is gaining traction and increasing in popularity by the day. And while people continue to use it, it forms part of our daily lives, a habit difficult to break. By the time any allegations are made, will it be too late? Do you think TikTok is here to stay? Or maybe you have concerns about how your personal data is used, or even that the Chinese government may be using your data to plan a cyber attack. I know one thing, I and many others feel hopeless when it comes to restricting the data smartphone apps can access. What's more, should you be concerned about TikTok or all social media apps as a whole? After all, China to the US is exactly what the US is to China. Both countries have a very powerful footprint in the global economy. Be sure to let us know what you think.